is kind of awesome, double IV. And can I just put them on? You don't say anything. I say, hey, George, we're in the Starbucks near your building. There's a business that I need help with and foreign fund you. We're not sure it'll be for you at all. Can you come back? Can you come right down? Can you take a break? He comes down, I'll present it to him. George says, it looks interesting, but it's funny. He'll have like one of the four major objections. Usually it's no time. In Singapore, it's MLM, or no sales, or no money. And I'll cover each of those objections in a second. So I'm going to say, great, George, so who do you know? He says, how about Elizabeth? Elizabeth is a Sun Yi. And Sun Yi, because she's Asian, gets it. And Sun Yi goes, fantastic, I'm going to go. When's the train? I immediately call Elizabeth and say, thank you for Sun Yi. We need to talk, because when the train is now leaving the station. And if you ever were interested, now is the time to get involved. And then I call George and I say, this is the lighting the fire that burns upward. And you do this all the time. Instead of you go wide for show and you go deep for depth. You just drive the line. I hate that sort of like manipulate, but basically you're going to make it happen for people. Because they can't make it happen themselves. Not in the beginning. It's too hard. The rejections drive them back. Once you get to be a pro at this, that's what you do. Is you make it happen for other people. And that doesn't happen in other corporations, does it? This is the only structure by which you get ahead by helping other people. You build the pyramid and help other people be successful. That's the key to this. So that's the contacts. Next is inviting. And there's all kinds of different ways to invite. One of them is the headhunter asks. Anyone ever been headhunted? They call you up and say, Florence, I'm sorry, what do you do? What was your day job before? You don't have to tell your whole story. Later we'll make you. No. So what did you do before? Let's say before doing this, what was your career?
Teaching Chinese.
And privately or in an institution?
In school.
So Florence, listen, I'm with Spencer Stewart. We're a major head-on company, and we're with a global firm who's looking for something to head up a program in Beijing to really take their Mandarin program to the next level. Who do you know who has experience and worked in Singapore at this level, and does this, and this, and this, and I describe you. Who do you know? Well, me. And this is how headhunters work, because they know they might be on a recorded line. And they say, oh, can you meet for a coffee? And then this is exactly how this works. So I'll do this with you. Florence, ring, ring. Listen, I've got a business that's going really fast. I need help. Who do you know who's entrepreneurial, coachable, open to another source of income in addition to what they're doing now, and is probably interested in what we do? And you might say, well, what is it? What do you do? Well, it's gene science. It's anti-aging. Well, actually, that's something interesting. Really? I never thought that. But when we have a coffee to talk about it. So that's one approach. The other is more direct, or you can also do this. Now, I'm going to teach you the six C's of inviting. Okay? This works in everything in life. Okay, first thing to do when you call someone or you're going to text them is you clear the time. Then you compliment, you create curiosity, that's what we did before, you control yourself, you give them a choice, and you get commitment. Sorry, I'm getting very low here. I can't read that well from the back. Okay, I'm going to just give an example. So, Sui Swan. Ring, ring, ring. Hey, Sui Swan, it's Bob.
Hello.
Long time no talk. Listen, I want to catch up and we're going to do that. I'm running out the door. You have just a quick minute?
Yeah.
Great. So, look, I've always admired your entrepreneurial spirit. You were so successful in corporate life, but you've had several different ventures. I really admire that. I'm not sure that this would be for you. But if there were a company that were growing really, really fast and you could build an, you know, an annuity income that would basically be your retirement in 3 to 5 years, would you at least take a quick look at it?